Y'all need to talk to me. What has been going on these Twitter space streets for the last couple of days? I'm not fully abreast on what's happening. There's a lot of infighting going on, so I want to get brought up to speed with some of this stuff. Y'all let me know what's going on. I don't really know everything that's going on. How did all this stuff get started? What the hell happened, guys? What's going on? I'm sitting around here waiting on this baby to come through. I'm waiting on baby Quoquo Nisha, and I'm seeing just all types of backs and forths going on the Twitter space streets, man. What's happening? All right, who can put me abreast? T.S. Giselle, sir, ma'am, you know, I'm not bringing you on. No, because you're one of these people that stay in the mix, and that's another thing. We got to start cleaning up these Twitter streets. That's one thing we're going to have to start doing, because leaving a lot of loose ends around here creates a lot of negative shrapnel that eventually builds up and spills over. So we got to start cleaning these Twitter streets up. Y'all, let me know what's going on. Let me talk to some people who can keep me abreast on what's happening here. What's up, Michael Oxhard? Let me see what's up. What's up, Michael? What's up, Michael?
Yo, what's going on, brother Tariq?
I'm good, man. What's on your mind, brother?
Niggas just over here chilling, you know what I'm saying? In LA, sipping on that Irk and Jerk, feeling good.
All right. Anything on your mind, brother?
No, niggas just chilling, man.
All right. Well, keep on chilling, brother. Much respect to you. All right. All right. Y'all getting your little drink on. That's what it is. You don't have to let me know you're getting your drink on. If y'all hear a blender, that's my lady in here making some acai bowls. All right. Listen, y'all let me know what's going on, man. What happened with all of this stuff? There was some stuff going on with some of the Freedmen people, some of the Secure the Tribe people, with our good brother Jason Black. Some people were taking shots at Professor Black Truth. And what the hell is all of this about, man? What's all this about, man? Talk to me. What's happening? Let's get some clarity and let's get some straightening going on. Let's get all this stuff together. Let me get my brother Elevation in here. Elevation can kind of bring some light to what's happening, I think. Brother Elevation, what's up, family?
When I expose Yashika Macklin for making those remarks about you and the FBA in general.
Who?
Yashika Macklin. She was on Clubhouse and she kept going in on you, going in on FBA. She made a lot of disrespectful remarks about you.
I don't quite remember, but you know, people talk crap about me online all the time. So what about now? Now who is she exactly?
Okay. So she's one of these Indians or one of the Secure the Tribe people. She did that in one of their spaces. Now they claim plausible deniability by saying that they were asleep, they didn't know she was talking this, that, and the third. But I still contend to this day she was a proxy for how they really felt. That's why when I tweeted you, and I tagged them, I want to see what their input was. None of them had anything to say. But fast forward to now, bottom line, they're trying to steal clout for themselves to reposition themselves as being the new black media. That's why they're trying to redefine what black first means as black American first. And that's what the whole, the gist was. In a nutshell, you know, we're not going to go on and on and on. That's it.
Okay. All right. Let me get some. Thank you so much, Brother Elevation. All right. Let me get some more folks to chime in and let us know what's going on here. Because, again, I'm in the dark. I don't know. And let's be very clear. Let's be very clear. There are a lot of folks in these Twitter spaces. And let's be clear. A lot of Twitter space doesn't represent a lot of stuff that happens out here on these streets. All right. Let's be clear on that. But in these Twitter spaces, you see a lot of folks who's coming around and acting like they're down, but a lot of them are low-key tethers. A lot of them own something else. Let me get my brother Montana in here to help bring some clarity on what's going on. What's up, brother Montana? Brother Montana?
What's going on, brother Flitz? How you feeling tonight?
I'm good, man. Now, what's the deal? What's happening out here, man? What's going on with everybody?
Man, all right. So, pretty much, long story short, we got a bunch of off-code, sensitive, disrespectful people. You know, in Secure the Tribe, we don't even never use the B1 hashtag. Really don't. You know what I'm saying? But I guess TBA decided to have a space to clear up what he said B1 meant. And he said, in all things that matter, B1 is replacing Pan-Africanism. And our response to that was, we're not with that. My interests are for Black Americans only. Black Americans always. That's it. You know what I'm saying? And we can respectfully agree to disagree and move forward towards reparations. But all the disrespect and all the coming at everybody like, you know, people don't have no information just because they're young and don't know what they're talking about. It's like, if we're going to have a public discourse, if you go ask me, you know, well, what's after delineation? And I tell you, well, it's aggregation. It's coming together and putting our businesses together. It's coming together and rebuilding our communities and in our 10-block radius. I can go on a list of things that you do once you delineate. You know what I'm saying? That's the whole purpose. And if we go get reparations in a time where flat Blackness is dangerous to us, delineation is the most important thing. So we're going to continue to beat the drum in order to make sure that we can get the message out to as many people as possible to do your lineage, do your family history, do your own personal search, because there's nothing more important to you than your own personal lineage and rebuilding your family tree. That's nothing. And if we can do that and continue to link up with other families that's doing that, then that's how we can continue to build the Black Kingdom. But he didn't want to have that conversation. He kept just coming at niggas like, just because we young and just because I look like this, niggas don't have no information. You know what I'm saying? And that's when I'm like, bro, if you're supposed to be the person that's out here pushing the message, why are you not investing the time in the young people that's out here trying to beat the drum with you? You know what I'm saying? That's disingenuous and disrespectful. If you want to have a public discourse, let's talk and we can respectfully move forward. But all that disrespect and shit, I don't tolerate that shit from nobody. I don't give a fuck what it is or what you doing. You know what I'm saying? Once you start coming at me and start talking about my mama and shit like that, bro, you don't know my motherfucking mama. You don't know my people. My folks done had land since motherfucking 1867. You know what I'm saying? You don't know what is in my lineage. So don't sit here and disrespect me and come at me like I'm just some simple person. That's lame and that's off code. And I stand on that. That's some off-code ass shit to do your people like that.
Okay, now with our brother Jason, now I know for a fact that he's a brother who's down with foundational Black Americans being prioritized first. Let's be very clear. We know that he's about that. He's not really on some Pan-Africanism stuff. So let's not get anything misconstrued with that. That brother's on code. That, you know, I guess the little insults back and forth, that's nothing to really blow up the spot about. You know what I'm saying? Because I don't think it was, that doesn't sound like it was some real personal stuff. It seems like a lot of stuff is getting blown up like crazy. Look, that brother's on code. You guys are on code for us getting what we're supposed to get as foundational Black Americans. We need to hold that energy right there. The other stuff is just unnecessary. Some of that stuff we got to charge to the game. Let me tell you something. Listen. Some of that shit, man, you got to let it slide. There's a lot of stuff that goes on in these Twitter spaces that I be hearing about certain people that people be cock-kind and kikiing with. And like our brother Elevation just called up and said, some of these folks have talked greasy on Clubhouse and then they come in these rooms, cock-kind and kikiing. I hear about all of that stuff. There's folks in here who I didn't got reports on who say little slick stuff and be in the room, cock-kind, kikiing. At the end of the day, you know what? I don't give a shit because we got bigger things to focus on. Now, I might take a little time to roast some people here or there, but I got bigger fish to fry. We're looking at these reparations bills. We're looking to see what they're going to do as far as getting us tangible. So we always got to get back and stay focused on that. a lot of the little bickering and petty stuff, we don't let that blow the spot up too much. Sometimes it's good to get the bullshit off your chest. That's why we roast every now and then. We do a little roasting and then, bam, we snap back into what we need to focus on. But we don't need to blow the whole spot up over some petty bullshit, because that's, at the end of the day, it's petty bullshit that people are bickering over from what I'm hearing. All right?
But yeah, people Brother Flex, real quick, and I don't mean to cut off, much respect, but it's like, it's certain things, like, if we come into you and we talk about what we did for Save Mason, Tennessee, you know what I'm saying? You would turn around and say, oh, what, y'all didn't do nothing because y'all, and if you ask one person that can't explain it, if you go look at the GoFundMe, it explains everything that we've been raising money for, whether that's for legal help, whether that's for infrastructure, whether that's for bringing business down there, whether that's for paying out the people that's on the government officials that haven't even been able to get paid because the mayor down there got to work two jobs. It's a lot of things on the GoFundMe, and that's up to the people, and we are in contact with those people, which you can't, but we could have had that conversation, you know what I'm saying? But you go belittle that when we talk about, okay, we've been doing all these meetings, half of the people that
who belittled the stuff for Mason,
TBA pretty much saying, well, yeah, they see, that's what I'm saying, y'all don't have a plan. You come in here and you just talk all day and you just but after that it's no plan. I'm like, bro, we could have had this conversation. That I would have told you what the plan was. I would have loved for you to tap in and see what the plan was, and so we could have pushed it even more. That's what we all supposed to be doing here, you know what I'm saying? But when we trying to have a conversation, you like, oh, you making jokes and shit like that, like, yeah, it's a time to joke and it's a time to be serious. We're supposed to be having a family conversation so we can get down to business, you know what I'm saying? I pulled up to the reparations meeting, you know what I'm saying? I'm finna be at the Juneteenth. I'm doing the whole Juneteenth reparations. I'm building that right now. This is in the works to make sure that this shit don't get co-opted, you know what I'm saying? Y'all pulled up to the California. April called them folks. We all been, this is not just Twitter. We linking up and doing the work, but you gonna belittle that and make it seem like, well, we just on Twitter just talking. No, we not on Twitter just talking. We just don't talk about everything on Twitter because that's not smart. That's not strategic. Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, but he didn't want to have that discourse. And that's when I'm like, that's when the disrespect come in. It's like, bro, if we all beating the same drum and we all supposed to be on it, then even if you don't fuck with me, then I don't give a fuck. Well, you can be in your lane, I can be in my lane. We all here to the reparations. That's cool. You know what I'm saying? But we supposed to be bouncing off and using each other as a resource and a catalyst in order to beat this drum over overall message. And if we can't even get it together between each other respectfully, how the fuck we gonna get them? That's the whole problem. You know what I'm saying? And so that's just been my sentiment. And if you go...
we're going to get it together. We're getting it together. We're getting this together. We're getting all this together. We're getting everything straight because, yeah, we're not going to have a whole bunch of up in the air stuff. We got too many real, real, real serious things to focus on. So we the last thing we need to do is be off focus. So, yeah, we're getting... This is why we're getting everything out. Let everybody say how they feel, what their grievances are. Get everything on the table so we'll know how to pull things back and organize and get things back straight so that we'll focus on what we need to focus on. Let me get some more of the Secure Brothers in here. I see Booby in here. Thank you so much, Brother Montana, man. Much respect to you, brother. I see Booby in here. Let's get Booby in here. Then I'll get Afro Elite in here. We're going to get everybody. We're going to get some straightening tonight. What's up, Brother Booby?
Hey, what's happening, Brother Tariq? Yeah, man. I don't need to go over the B1 situation. It was a misunderstanding. We really thought it was Black American First. He said it's, you know, Black globally. We like, okay, we ain't with it. It's basically some Pan-African shit. So we like, ain't with it. We moving on with it. But I just really wanted to touch on what Elevation Ally said. Just real quick, that American Indian, she's not a part of Security Tribe. She one of them clubhouse Indians that came over, you know, basically interjected herself, tried to make this shit about the Americas, adding South America. You know, you came into the space with Sonny, with the FBA American Indian. You was in there, so she's not a part of it. We called out on it, let her know we not on that America shit. It's about the USA, so I just wanted to point that out with Elevation Ally. It was really some bullshit he was on. So he got a personal situation with us. It's cool, but don't lie. You know what I'm saying? We never let nobody slander you. We always bigged you up in our spaces, so... There's no video of us or nothing condoning, no slandering. So I hate when people lie. You know what I mean? Post the receipts if they got it. But don't come up here and lie like that. That's that bullshit.
Yes.
That's it.
No doubt. Thank you so much for clearing that up, Sonny. Yeah. So listen. So this is why everybody got to be focused. This is why we got to be focused. This is why we got to be focused, family. We got to be focused. We got to be codified. You see, we got to be codified. Because look, again, because if we see one thing happening and then there's reports that it's happening somewhere else, because I've seen rooms where you had just people straight up trolling and talking crazy and people just sitting up in there. And I'm kind of looking at folks funny style. So we got to be, you know, we got to see what's going on. Because listen, when those tethers come in here, when they hop in this space, well, security tribe did this. I don't know. No. Y'all not going to talk about them brothers. I check their asses. I go in on them heavy. I don't let them sit up here talking about no FBA. You don't get to come up in here and say anything reckless or crazy about no FBA person at all. I shut that bullshit down real, real quick. I'm not trying to caca and kiki with nobody. You do not say anything about anybody, FBA, in a negative way, especially if you're a non-FBA. You see, I be slashing and dashing on these assholes out here. I don't play with these folks at all. That's called codification. We got to be on that wave. There's a lot of stuff that happens in these rooms. And sometimes the disagreements that can lead to interesting conversations. Sometimes when the white supremacists call up, I use that as a learning tool. I want them to call up with some of their opposing views to show you guys how to handle them. With a lot of black people with opposing views, if it's good faith arguments, I don't mind having that discourse. But a lot of times you have niggas just popping in, acting up for attention and trying to suck all the energy out of the room so that we're just stagnant. And I was thinking about that the other day. We're going to have to clean up a lot of stuff that happens in these rooms if we're going to continue to have some constructive dialogue. Even if we oppose somebody's opinions, if it's in good faith on their part, it can still be constructive. For example, some of these Democratic shills will call up here, even though I vehemently disagree with them telling us to vote for immigration and all that goofy nonsense. I like to have the conversation to show you guys their talking points and how to counter it. Some of these folks who are known to come in these rooms trolling, also some of these people who are complete agents, that black nationalist dude that makes multiple accounts, that dude is clearly on some type of agent provocateur. Somebody's sending that dude. That's the type of stuff we shouldn't even entertain. Truth be told, even though we get a lot of shits and giggles out of it, we gotta, and me too, I'm gonna put this on me too, people like T.S. Giselle, we're gonna have to clean that up and stop letting T.S. Giselle get in these rooms and suck the energy out, unfortunately. I know it's funny to kind of go back and forth to get a little comic relief, but sometimes we're just gonna have to clean that stuff up and just not have people coming in with no constructive dialogue whatsoever. That one dude that's singing Sambo from St. Louis who comes in everybody's room trolling, that dude has to go. We got to stop letting these folks get microphones. You understand? These people who have absolutely nothing constructive to bring to the conversation, some of these clubhouse trolls who have nothing constructive, we got to charge them to the game. Again, it's good to have opposing views sometimes, but just sitting around having troll fest when we're supposed to be having constructive dialogue, especially about certain issues pertaining to our reparations and other things culturally relating to foundational Black Americans. I saw some other dialogue today. There were some people upset with not just Jason Black, but with Professor Black Truth. There were some people upset with him. Who was upset with that brother, and what was that about? Well, let's get everything cleared up. Let me see some hands. Some people had some issues with Professor Black Truth. Now, what was that about? I kind of got a little understanding about that. I would like for some folks to chime in. Let me get Afro Elite in here. Brother Afro Elite.
Hey, Tariq, can you hear me?
I'm good, brother. How are you?
I'm good. Okay. I'm not going to necessarily say any names, and I'm going to try to keep this as brief and concise as possible. But for the last few months, majority of the members of Secure the Tribe have been saying that Black only means foundational Black Americans, and that nobody else from the diaspora is Black, and that the concept of Black doesn't exist, and Black is not a race. I've made spaces, and I've sent multiple clips from your YouTube channel, Jason Black's YouTube channel, and Professor Black Truth's YouTube channel, pretty much trying to break down what Black means and how we should be moving with a B1 mindset. And that doesn't necessarily mean that we cape for immigration or we're on Pan-Africanism, because I've stated multiple times, even on my YouTube, that I'm not a Pan-Africanist, but that doesn't mean we don't have on code brothers and sisters from the diaspora. We just rock with the people.
Right.
We just rock with the people who's on code and the ones who's off code. And unfortunately, majority of the diaspora, they're just not on code. But the ones who are on code, we can rock with them. And, you know, they don't, most of them don't get that concept because they don't feel like Black is a race. And they've abandoned that. And then they've said that B1 means Black America first. So Jason made a space and he said, okay, I'm going to clear this up. When he scheduled the space in the morning, Secure the Tribe made spaces talking about, well, Jason is not the leader. He doesn't even show his face, so we don't have to pay attention to him. Then they started bringing up old memes from Yvette Carnell talking about he's like a woman beater, and they started slandering Jason the whole day prior to his space. And I got clips and screenshots and all of that. So when they came in Jason's space and they switched up the energy, they was like, hey, Jason, you know, I was just a little bit confused about what B1 means. You know, we're all in this together. They switched up the energy, and Jason called them out. He was like, I know what you've been saying about me. I've been seeing what you guys have been posting. I've been seeing all of this stuff. And that's when he kind of snapped off on him, because he's like, I don't respect the fact that you're not coming in the space with the same energy you just had in the space before. So that's kind of where the back and forth between Jason and Secure the Tribe came from, because after that, they was making spaces all night long, dissing Jason and talking about Professor Black Truth, talking about B1 and everybody else, and saying that FBA are the only people who are Black and everybody else is a tether. So that's really where the confusion, or that's really where the beef between Jason and Secure the Tribe came from. And I got all of the screen recordings and all of that stuff to back up what I'm saying. This has been going on for like a few months now, to be honest. It's been like stirring up for a few months now.
Okay, now I got Montana in here. I want to let Montana, I got him back up here. Mute your microphone, Afro Elite. Montana, unmute yourself, brother.
Appreciate it, family.
Go ahead, brother.
Appreciate it, family. First of all, what he's doing is he's conflating and jumping from back and forth between two spaces. You know what I'm saying? The first person to bring any type of B1 disruption to any space was Afro. He came to Secure the Tribe spaces and started trying to tell us what B1 means, et cetera, et cetera. We told him straight up that we don't care about that. What we care about is delineating and Black Americans. We over here personally want to deal with Black Americans, and the identity of being Black, everything about being Black comes from American culture, because your lineage and your culture is hand in hand. There's no way. The reason why Japanese fried rice is different from Chinese fried rice is because one of them uses coconut oil and the other one uses peanut oil. That's because what is indigenous to that land. Your culture and your lineage is hand in hand. Everything that makes us Black is hand in hand. You wouldn't have any fuck the police if it wasn't for police brutality. It wouldn't be no trap music if it wasn't for war on drugs. Everything that makes us Black and makes a Black identity comes from our culture, and we're the only people throughout the diaspora that can show documentation that actually has colored Black and Negro on it. Other people throughout the diaspora don't have to classify as Black because they haven't had the experience that we've had. That's what we're saying. It has nothing to do with anybody or being not one to do. No, we are interested in Black Americans, and nobody else can take that culture, because that's our culture. Because if you want to know how to become classified, you look at other people, and that's what the Mexicans did. They said we have a specific language and culture, even if we have the descendants of Spaniards that came over here and we might be related to them, we have our own distinct language and culture, and that's how they became Mexicans. Well, the same thing with us. We have our own distinct language and culture. Respect Ebonics, because Ebonics Ebonics was the same thing that English was to the Great Britain. Respect our Ebonics, respect our Tetanese. And if I tell you, go, hash your mummy, tutty, tut, huddy, rut, respect that, because it's my ancestral land. That's what we're saying. So it don't have. So he the one who brought the dissension. And the whole thing with TBA was just the disrespect. That's all that I had a problem with. That's all. If you say you want to, if your interests are black globally, that's fine. My interest is black in my family. It's black in my community. It's black American. That's my issues. And we can, still the goal is reparations. But it wasn't no confusion, and it wasn't trying to remix nothing. This Sissy and Punk, he couldn't come in the spaces and handle the heat. And so he ran, starting to send DMs, and he all this. I've been sitting in spaces, and I've been gathering intel and screenshots. And we're like, bro, who is you, bro? You sound like the police, bro. Get out of our spaces with all that fan talk. What are you doing? And he got mad and wanted to go and run up and throw all this dissension, because I'm from the streets, and when you come to my spaces, and we can have a public discourse like this. But once you start getting your feelings, and then I start looking at screenshots, and you've been sitting in the spaces since Mason, Tennessee, and you was all nice and polite, and wanted to come up and raise your hand and ask questions, but now 2-3 months later, you are up here bold, holding spaces, talking about, like, bro, that's some police fed stuff, and that's where all this came from. So don't come up here trying to cape and talk nice. And I didn't go in there and talk nice, and I got recordings. I went in there respectful, but I ain't go up there no tiptoe, nothing. And he dropped me from the stage 2 nights in a row, because I brought that heat, because I can back up everything that I'm talking about. And just like I tell all y'all don't want to sit down with me and have a debate about information, because my folks been doing it, my lineage. We've been on this. This ain't nothing new. So stop coming up here caping and capping, because I just look like this.
There you go. All right, man. Thank you so much, Montana. Let me get some more folks in. Listen, family, because I don't want people just to go into a back and forth about certain terms like B1. B1 is, I don't know why people are having such a big debate about it, saying that it's about Pan-Africanism. From what I can't redefine it. You know, I don't know. I didn't listen to Jason's thing where he was explaining it. But from what I understand, it means that you're just going to be on code with black people, whoever they are. Now, listen, I'm a foundational black American. I'm prioritizing foundational black Americans right now. Everything is about FBA right now. But understand this. I travel internationally. And many of you travel internationally, and many of you are going to travel internationally. When we travel internationally, we have to understand there's a lot of black folks out there. Even though we have different lineages, as black people globally, there are some people who are on code. And I rock with those people who are on code with us. Are there a bunch of damn tethers who ain't on code? Yes. Absolutely. This is why we're calling them out, getting them out of our spaces and not letting them be our representatives. I won't say getting them out of our spaces, but getting the anti-FBA tethers out of positions where they're acting as buffers against us. You see, we had to do a lot of house cleaning as far as foundational Black Americans. There were a couple of casualties of war with some of the good brothers and sisters from the diaspora. But understand, we still do have some riders, and I rock with them. And I do want to make sure that they're fine as fellow black people. Let's be very clear. There's a case out there where there was some black kids being hurt out there in the UK. I'm, you know, promoting and putting the word out for that story for my black friends in the press over there in the UK. I got a lot of good folks over there in the UK who works in media. Listen, you definitely want allies if you can get them. You don't need them. But if you get other black people who are on code, wherever they are, you pop your collar to them and you rock with them. I'm all for rocking with black folks anywhere they are, as long as they're on code. I respect their culture. They respect my foundational Black American culture. You understand? There's nothing wrong with being on code and looking out for that person if the opportunity presents itself. Now, I'm not talking about us just putting the cape on for other groups like we've always done. We have to get home taken care of. We've been doing this caping for a long time, and what we're doing now, we're prioritizing ourselves so that we won't be ass out. But understand, when we go out here in the world, when we travel around the globe, when we run into some good, thorough brothers and sisters in Africa, who's some brothers over there in Europe, you got a lot of brothers over there in Dubai. If you got some riders, I pop my collar to them. Listen, I got some riders. I'm talking about some for real riders in the damn UK. They were putting in work in the streets for us over here. When we started turning up over here with the George Floyd thing, I had some riders over there putting in some damn work on them white supremacists in the UK. I pop my damn collar to them all day, every day. Family, there's a reason why they done banned me out of the UK. They banned me from there because I have so many riders over there. They were like, your ass can't come back over here ever. They'll arrest me if I go to the UK. I pop my collar to them brothers and sisters over there who's riders. Let's be clear. But when it comes time to taking care of what we need to take care of as far as foundational Black Americans, I put that on the front line, you see? But we do have to understand there's a time when we're going to have to get on code with other brothers and sisters who are on code, even if we come from different ethnic backgrounds, because that's where your power is. You take care of home and then you take the show on the road. The white supremacists understand that. When a white supremacist leaves here, even though they have differences with Irish and English and all these other people, when they get around other Black folks and they see some of their fellow white people, they get on code with each other. That's where their power is. Let me tell you something. Asian people, they don't get along. Asian groups don't get along. Over there, me and my wife was on a plane. Where were we on that plane, Lexi? Was it China? These folks were fighting on the damn plane. They were beating each other's ass in midair, nigga. They were whooping each other's ass. They were doing kung fu on that damn plane. It was kung fu plane, nigga. You heard of Kung Fu Panda. It was kung fu plane. They were beating each other's asses on that plane in midair. They didn't even stop the flight. Me and my wife was terrified. They don't like each other over there. But let me tell you something. All those Asian groups, when they came over here and then when it came time to support Peter Liang after he killed a Kai Gurley, a Black man, all of these Asian groups who have different ethnic differences, they all got in the damn streets and hold hands with each other. They held hands to march against us. You understand? All of them right now are on that Stop Asian Hate. That's something that's really against us. To put Black people as the face of Asian hate crimes. All of these Asian groups. I put up a flyer for this event that Kamala Harris is having. Now she's Asian again, by the way, guys. Your sister girl Kamala, she's Asian again. So she's having some kind of Asian political event with Jenny May, Jeezy's wife, some other Asian actresses and actors, and Karrueche's Black ass. Now she's Asian again. So, yeah, they all get on code, even though they come from these different ethnic backgrounds. You understand? And I look at this as the same thing. If there's on code brothers from wherever, if you're on code with me, and we're in a situation where we need reinforcements for each other, I got you as long as you got me. So in my perspective, that's how I see the B1 thing. You just look out for other people who are on code. That doesn't mean you don't prioritize the FBA family. Because right now, FBA family is next in line right here. Now, we're not next in line. We're at the line. It's all about FBAs right now. Let's be very, very clear. We're just not prioritizing a whole bunch of other stuff. We're prioritizing FBA business right now. Let me get some more folks in here. I'll get you back on in a second, Afro Elite. Let me get some more people on here to chime in. Everybody raise your hand. Let's get Ben Yosef in here. Just trying to get some straightening so that we don't have a lot of up-in-the-air energy going on out here. And again, I want to see what was people's issue with Professor Black Truth, too. Because, yeah, they were throwing, you know, there was shrapnel all over the place. Willie Lowe, get your ass out of here, dude. Man, get your ass out of here. You're not coming in here tonight, man. You goofball. How'd I block you, man? I'm blocking you. Like, this is another thing. These goofball trolls, we got them cleaning things up right now. I just blocked that dude. sometimes we have people in here for shits and giggles. Who is this guy? Stepper? Yeah, you hop in, Stepper. Hop in. Hop in, Stepper. Stepper, hop in. I get Ben Yosef in a minute. Let's get this Stepper dude in here. Stepper, turn your microphone. Oh, he bounced. Okay, why'd you bounce, Stepper? All right, Stepper, let's try it again, man. Get on. All right, Stepper, hop in. Okay, this nigga's bullshit. Okay. Hold on 1 second. All right. Okay. All right, Stepper, what we doing, man? Because this raggedy phone thing ain't working right now for you. All right, Stepper. All right, turn your microphone on, man. Okay. All right, well, we're waiting on Stepper with his janky phone. Let's get Ben Yosef in here.
Hey, what's up, brother Tariq, man? The thing with Jason last night, he was just basically cleaning house with Security Tribe. We had some people that was off cold, April and Sherelle, who were bed winching. He exposed their tweets, and he just said, but basically, they got to be watched. You know, we got to just keep an eye on these people out here, because you got a lot of swirlers and bed winches that are in Security Tribe that are trying to protest and out other people for being bed winches. So basically, he was just trying to clean house, and that's all that was, and people got in their feelings about it.
No doubt. Okay. Got it. Thank you so much for the call, Ben. Appreciate you. All right. Stepper, you ready?
Yeah. Yo, what's going on, Ty? I'm ready.
Okay. Now what's happening, man? What's on your mind?
Yo, man, there's just been a lot of craziness that I think there's a lot of misdirecting. I think the focus should be more on reparations than it is, you know, people, you know, getting on here dealing with their personal issues, man. I think that's a big problem when it comes to just people focusing up on the reparations and just banding together. Even though we're coming to more of an understanding of what who we are, it's just a problem of how we're going to do it and how we're going to go about it. And I think there's just, you know, a little divisiveness with that.
Now, the people were saying stuff about you. Now, are you Puerto Rican or something? Are you mixed? Are you like an anchor baby or something?
I'm not Puerto Rican, bro. That's just a rumor, you know. From me calling out some folks over the Mason, Save Mason, Tennessee, I criticized those folks over there on that side because I didn't think there was a good cause in paying the government back. And they was, you know, raising money, whatever. But I'm not all too concerned about that. I'm more concerned about getting the reparations. I'm not Puerto Rican, brother.
All right. And again, I've seen you personally. I've seen some of your tweets where you've been talking a little reckless. You've talked real reckless. You've talked a little slick. But I don't trip on that. I don't trip on that at all. But I've seen your little ass. I've seen you talk slick. But that's water off a duck's ass, man. I don't really trip on it too much.
I'm
watching your ass. You understand? I'm still watching your ass.
I'm watching you.
But thank you for the call. Thank you, brother. Yeah, that dude right there, that Stepper dude, he didn't say a little old slick ass stuff. I didn't see him. I've seen you. Oh yeah, let's get some straightening up in here. Let's get some straightening. There were some people who kind of made a slick comment, and he's there cock-eyeing and kikiing with him. I've seen you, nigga. I've seen him. This is what I'm letting y'all know. I see a lot of little old slick talk here and there, but I'm so focused, I don't even trip on that stuff. You see, I'm extremely focused. You know, I don't really be cock-eyeing and kikiing with cats all day. And, you know, part of the game, somebody, you know, people are going to talk reckless. People are going to talk greasy. You still stay your ass focused. That's the point I'm trying to make to the family. Some of these names people are dropping, I've been hearing stuff about them talking reckless. That April chick that people are bringing up, people came to me saying that she has talked very reckless about me in the past. And she's been in here, Kakan and Kikin. I'd never brought it up. You know why? Don't care. I'm focused. Ladies and gentlemen, I am focused on what we need to get as a collective. Some person that I don't know saying something about me, I don't really give a shit. nothing to make me really trip on them. I keep my eye on them. I watch how they are allowed to move in certain spaces, but I'm so secure, I don't give a damn. People talk reckless all the time. That's going to happen. That's not going to take me off my focus because there is no leadership. The code is the leadership. It's always the code for me. I'm focusing on the code, and the code is the leadership. Now, when there's bickering and stuff like that, we shouldn't put too much energy in that because everybody ain't going to be in a position where we're just sitting around singing Kumbaya. That's just not going to happen. We have to expect this. This is kind of good to a certain degree to let us know that everything ain't going to be all about holding hands, kicking cans, and looking in each other's eyes with the love of Jesus. It's not going to be about that. Certain ethnic groups are going to have differences, ideological differences, economic differences, political differences. But what's important is the overall code at the end of the day. You understand? That's what we have to understand. We got to learn how to play past all of these little petty differences. As we're talking now, we see this. That stuff don't make no difference whatsoever about nothing. It's a bunch of nothing. At the end of the day, it's not really that big of a deal. As long as we're still being focused. Let me get my brother Black Alpha Network in here. Let's get all the stuff on the table. Let everybody know how you feel as far as any type of disrespect, whatever's going on, family. This is good. We're getting all this stuff out. Black Alpha, what's up, brother?
Peace, brother Tariq. Hey, first off, I want to commend you for putting this space together. It's a real OG move. This is what happened.
Yes, sir.
You know, when the house get out of line, somebody got to put it in order. And I want everybody, you know, I want everybody to know it's okay to have a disagreement. It's a disconnection.
Yeah.
That's the problem. You know, the disconnection is the issue. You got the disagreement. We can work through that. We got a long history of working things out together. But I want them to know is that every time we have these public debates and public disputes, these other people out here staring the pot. They staring the pot.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are. The tethers are doing the Birdman hand right now.
They're rubbing their hands left to right. You know, the tethers.
Rubbing them little ashy hands together right now.
They need some damn lotion, man. They need a little bit of damn. I know, I'm going to take it back to what you said as well, brother, about Clubhouse. That's why you jumped off of Clubhouse. You said it was like talking on the Fed line.
Yeah, you know? Yeah. It was ridiculous. But, man, I appreciate you, man. Thank you so much. But yeah, family, we're going to get this thing together because, look, I'm not taking no sides nowhere. I'm not taking any sides. I'm right. I'm neutral as hell. I'm right here in the middle. I'm neutral. I'm very neutral. I'm not taking anybody's side here. I am neutral all the way around. Even with some of the people who've been talking greasy that I didn't had on here, I'm not tripping on them, man. Look, if you're on code, cool. Whatever you feel about me personally, knock yourself out. Who gives a shit? Are you about the business of all of us getting the tangibles we need? That's all I care about. I'm not in the business of being liked. That's why I don't trip on none of that stuff. This ain't about a popularity contest. This ain't about love and affection. This is about codification and getting tangibles for our group. Our group is suffering. We need to make sure our group is fine. Our foundational Black American family, we need to make sure that they have tangibles. That's the only thing that I'm concerned with. Let me get some more people in here. We got a lot of folks in here. We're getting some straightening tonight. Let's get NFT, the dude with the Godzilla thing, on his page. What's up, brother? NFT? Hello? Okay, it's going to slow the show down with the janky-ass phone. Oh, well, is this April? Let's get April in here. April, hop in here, dear. April?
Hello, can you hear me?
I can hear you. What is going on, April?
All right. First thing, peace, power, and reparations to the people. First things first. April does not do drive-bys, right? I do walk-ups, right? So April hasn't said anything greasy about anyone. right, that I have not said and walked up to anyone and said, if I have a problem with you, in fact, I have defended you over and over, right? People may not like you, but one thing for certain, two things for sure, Tariq stays on code with lineage, and that is what I stay on code with lineage. Mm. So it ain't no greasiness, no, just like Ben came up here and slandered and lied on my name and said I was a bid wench and I've never slept with, I've never dated, I've never kissed a white person. There's actually tweets going around that I've given birth to white children, right? So it's slander, it's lies. And so I appreciate you, you know, not even giving it the energy, right? And that's really the ancestors, right? Because one thing for certain and two things for sure, I do not do drive-bys. I am very blunt. I am very direct. And if there was ever a problem, just like I pulled up on Jason, who requested an inbox to have a conversation today, right? No, I pull up. I don't do it. Ain't nothing greasy about April. So I wanted to make sure that was clear, as well as Ben, the predator, who we have messages of him being almost 40, inboxing 19-year-old children and asking them, you know, maybe they could have a family and go on dates, but he's up here. And we have that. We have actual receipts of that. We have the women and the young women whose inboxes that he was in. But he says that April made a tweet and now I've birthed and I'm a bed wench and I'm a divester, right? So it's a lot of slander. It's a lot of lies and blatant lies. And the difference is that I'm not just on Twitter, right? The work product is here. And, you know, people, you know, yesterday, last night, it was a lot of, oh, April this, and then, yeah, this morning, hey, I think we should talk about it today, right? No, you should have thought about that before slandering and allowing people to blatantly lie on my name, because I'm not a Twitter character. I'm not, right? The only focus is reparations. Reparations work happens literally every day. Legislation is being written. People are being confronted in their city offices on a daily basis, right? And nothing that we are doing is being discussed on Twitter. We're not talking about what are you going to do now? Or what are you going to do next? We ain't doing none of that dumb shit because we're playing chess, right? We've already thought about the next shit, the shit that we're going to be doing for the next 2 years up until 2024 to the national election, right? Like, literally. And no, we're not in Twitter spaces telling people what our next moves is, right? Because just having basic conversation about delineation has turned into people saying that people want clout and people want this. And now we have all these people are saying there's a beef. There ain't no beef. Y'all don't know what beef is. Beef is your mama can't come outside, right? Your kids is not safe in the school. Y'all don't know nothing about beef. Y'all talking about Twitter spaces and y'all not being able to be around everybody all of the time because you come around acting like a real weirdo and now people say, yo, dude, we don't really even want you around us, and now you upset and in your feelings, and now everybody, you literally went on peep somebody's stage the night and said, y'all need to pick a side. That's what Afro said. He also allows immigrants and tethers to be disrespectful to Black Americans, to foundational Black Americans, and especially our Black women, right? One of his tether friends called KD a hood rat and a roach, and I know for a fact that my good sis is
that's not true.
Hey, oh, he definitely did, right? We keep receipts.
Hold on, April. Let me get Afro. He's here. Let me have him speak on that and defend himself from that accusation, brother Afro. Speak on that, brother.
Yes. Okay. So, you know, I'm FBA on both sides. I've been FBA all the way back before when we was doing the ADOS thing. I fully agreed with Secure the Tribe when it came to reparations, when it came to doing your background checks. I was in the 30K space. I was in a lot of their spaces in the beginning. I was even in the spaces when they were talking about saving Mason, Tennessee. I was the one who recorded the first space with Judge Joe Brown, and me and D. Tubman work together to put that on YouTube. So shout out to D. Tubman about that.
Yeah.
Now, what she was talking about a space was a space that, first off, I wasn't hosting. It was a space with a Haitian brother who's B1. And this was after a argument between one of the members of Secure the Tribe. And she got up on stage and she was kind of just she got up on stage hosted by Black Alpha, who was an FBA, and she started, she like came there and she wanted problems and she started arguing with Rich, and then he kicked her off and said, you know, you're acting like a hood rat. Now, I wasn't even at my phone at the time, and then they messaged me. I had a whole bunch of people message me like, how are you going to let him say that? How are you going to let him say that? I didn't even hear him say that till I played the space back. But when I played it back, I'm like, okay, well, you know, I'm a, I can't say anything now. I had to play the space back. I talked to him. We got that settled, and that was that. The person that they're referring to doesn't go around saying anything about FBA. He's actually, I've seen him put his own Haitian people on blast several times. I don't rock with any tethers. I've been talking about FBA. I got FBA in my bio. I've been on this FBA path from the very beginning when you coined the term after Yvette Carnell and Antonio started pivoting from what they were supposed to be doing. So they're trying to come up here and snitch on me and tell on me. None of that is true at all. I try to come in their spaces and tell them what FBA means. FBA is our nationality. That's our ethnicity. That's our lineage. We sticking with FBA. But, you know, we can have a B1 mentality at the same time. That right. You don't have to have one or the other. They told me no. They said race does not exist. They told me that if you are not a Foundation Black American, you can't be B1. If you're not a Foundation Black, they're lying on me, brother. They're lying on me. I've been rocking with, I started, brother. I've been rocking with you since day one, man.
Right. There you go, man. I appreciate you, man. Thank you so much for bringing your side and your input to the conversation. This is why, again, let's put everything out here so we can get clarity. Let's get everything out here. Whatever disagreements people have, whatever grievances they have, let's get it on the table when people are here so that there's not a million rooms being made and people are just going back and forth all day. Let's just get this shit out and get everything cleared up. Nino, what's up, brother Nino?
What's good, brother Tariq?
How are you, sir?
I'm all right, man. I'm actually very glad that you're holding this space, man. First and foremost, brother, I've been rocking with you since 2015, man. I called this your Ism radio show and admitted that I was wrong about the no vote campaign. Been rocking with you ever since, man. I credit you with putting me on Dr. Wilson, you know, and all the Grandmaster Scholars, bro. You truly changed my life, brother. I've been rocking with you ever since. So I just want you to know, I'm about to tell you some things, and it's going to be God honest truth. The fact of the matter is, the Sakita tribe people, they're pulling the ADOS 2.0. They had a good hashtag and a good model that we all got behind, because I'm FBA on both sides. You know, I'm behind quote unquote delineation. You know, they run that word into the ground, but I'm behind that. You know what I'm saying? I agree. Most immigrants are not rocking with us. I agree. Most people throughout the diaspora are, you know, are not on code. So when I saw the Secure the Tribe hashtag, I got behind that. When the Mason, Tennessee thing, got behind it. I was on stage with them and Judge Joe Brown. I was there with Afro in a lot of these spaces. But I started noticing my antenna started going up when I started noticing. They started saying, well, if you're not FBA, you're not Black. And B1 means Black American First. Now, mind you, Tariq, you're the one that put me on to Jason Black. You put me on to Professor Black Truth. Again, brother, I'll say, You really changed my life since 2015. I know folks be like, oh, you know what, they're dick riding. But that's a God honest truth. You really had changed my life. You have put me on game. And with that being said, I'm noticing things. And my judge of character, I ain't going to lie to you, brother. I'm shooting 100% from the field. When I notice some off-code behavior, I'm the first one to call it out. I'm the tip of the spear, along with some other brothers and sisters. And people be hating me for it, but I end up being right. And the same thing's going on with the security trial thing. A lot of these people are new niggas who really don't rock with you, Tariq. They don't rock with you at all. They ain't never in your YouTube chat. I'm in your YouTube every week. Have been for the last, what, 6-7 years. And a lot of things, they're using terms and they're using our verbiage, but they don't even understand the meaning behind it. They talking about what's on code and what's off code. They don't even know the code. They ain't never read Nearly Fuller Jr. They ain't never read Dr. Wilson. They ain't never watched none of the lectures by Dr. Clyde Anderson. They're talking real good, but they don't even understand the things that they're talking about. And when Afro and I came in there in good faith to correct them on some of these things, then that's when they started pushing back on us. And then so me and Afro was trying to correct them on these things. I'm going to wrap it up real quick because I know you don't like people being long-winded. When me and Afro tried to correct them on a lot of these things, because we came in good faith, like, okay, maybe y'all just don't understand, so let's correct some misunderstanding. They started fighting back on us, and somehow it got to TBA, and TBA even came at them on some respectful stuff initially. But once he came in and corrected them and said B1 does not necessarily mean Black American first. That's not to say we don't put ourselves first. Everybody throughout the diaspora needs to put their home first. People in Jamaica, if you be one, you need to clean up Jamaica. If you be one in Nigeria, you need to clean up Nigeria. That way you can be of use to everybody else in the diaspora. So I'm all for us taking care of home first, securing our mass first. But when TBA corrected them on that and basically blew their whole spot up, now they're going on a jihad against him. And now Professor Black Truth, you know, he don't even speak on things like this. He's, you know how Professor Black Truth do.
Right. That's so why I wanted to know what was anybody's problem with Professor Black Truth? He don't get into no issues with nobody. So what was that about?
His association with TBA and Nasty, they pulling out the same rhetoric that Eddie OS did when y'all called out Eddie OS for the agent behavior they was on. And they start pulling out all the, you know, the same, I'm talking about word for word, same accusations against TBA and PBT. They pulling out the same thing, the same screenshots, the same, you know, accusing him of being somebody that he's not. All the same rhetoric. And I know why, because a lot of these people that's in the security tribe are former ADOS. April, for instance, is former ADOS. She denies it, but I have proof that she is. Me and Afro have proof about everything we're saying. Like, we're not just pulling stuff out of our ass.
Right. All right. Thank you so much, Nino, man. I appreciate you. I see Booby wants to get back on. Booby, hop back on, brother.
Yeah, man, this shit is here crazy, man. You seen that nigga Afro waited on stage. You went through about 5 niggas. Yeah, he was just sitting up there waiting. That's how much vitriol they got towards Security Tribe, man. Again, all we doing is standing on Black American business, man, and that's the problem. We didn't try to co-op B1. We thought it was Black American because, shit, he FBA, so we like, okay. He just thought that, you get what I'm saying? But he corrected it. He was like, no, you mean Black globally? We like, cool, bitch. That's how we took it. We like, nigga, that's Pan-Africanism. We gonna agree to disagree. But they have a problem with that. So, and that's really what the issue is. These boys don't know us from a can of paint. You get what I'm saying? I met Sonny Mill on Twitter. This ain't no, I don't know what they own, all these accusations. You get what I'm saying? This is Twitter, and we just come basically like a little small think tank where we converse and we, you know what I'm saying, pass ideas around or whatever and do what we do. But they have a problem with that shit because we got attention from the space and they want that shit. You can tell. You get what I'm saying? So, and that's really what it boils down to. You know what I mean? They make spaces about us, tweets about us. 24/7. We don't talk about these niggas. Security Tribe, we be on some. But, you know, they got some. I don't know what it is, you know. But that's really what it is, brother. They ain't got poster. I'm just saying, if they got some real receipts, send it to them. Because they sent all that shit to TBA. You get what I'm saying? They're talking about, I don't know how TBA know y'all. And y'all little rats, little fangirl clubs and sending him shit, but he don't have no receipts on us. He brought up that incident with the females that they talking about, but nothing with male Sonny Booby and Security Tribe, but nobody else. You get what I'm saying? They just really bringing up the receipts on the females, and that shit got handled already. You get what I'm saying? But, right. You know, it's just some jealousy now, really boils down to with the niggas.
Booby, let me ask you this. Now, let me ask you this. What some of the people who are in opposition to some of you brothers, some of the brothers and sisters that's in here now that's kind of in opposition, what understanding do you want them to have about your ideology?
Our ideology is basically we securing the tribe for Black America and Black America only. And listen, what's confusing to them, because we're not confusing our Blackness, because we understand that's our cultural and ethnic identity. You get what I'm saying? Like, so we're not confusing that with being on code, and that's what they don't like. You can be on code as a Jamaican, a Ghanaian, a Nigerian, but you're not Black. You're not finna take our identity. We're already dealing with our identity crisis. Niggas trying to take our shit and erase us. So that's what the problem is. We telling people they're not Black, and people have a problem with it. And it's cool. You can disagree, but we not off code. That's the only thing they have that's the real problem with it. Because we saying people outside of America are not Black. And we're not just saying that off a culture standpoint. We have documentation of us only being the ones classified as Black. And people don't like us spewing that rhetoric. I don't say rhetoric, but spewing the truth, because that's really what it is. And people are uncomfortable, especially the tethers. And the FBA people that love, they tether friends or whatever, cool. But we not on that. Secure the Tribe is about Black American business only. You get what I'm saying? And we gatekeeping our culture. That mean that Black term, that Negro term, everything about us, we gatekeeping it. And that's the real issue here.
Okay, so now if you do, you know, what if you have an ally or a brother who's from the diaspora who comes over and says, hey, man, I support what you guys do. You know, they got me on this reparations panel, and hell, I want to as a black person, I'm not FBA, but I want to vote to make sure you get reparations. Would you accept that person's input and allyship?
His input, no, but his contribution, yes. And that's another thing. We don't want no input from nobody on the outside. You can come contribute and listen, but y'all been over here damn near 8 decades. We don't need your input on nothing no more. Y'all had enough time to input. We passed that now. And see, that's the problem. People feel like we extreme, but we're not going to telling people to go attack immigrants. You feel me? It's plenty of us that know immigrants or have, you know, business or whatever, immigrant friends, but at the same time, we're putting us first and we're not trying to deal with them on no level until further notice. They can't be B1. They don't see themselves as B1. You was just on Fox Soul in the Caribbean, girl. We don't understand blackness till we get to America. So why the hell is we finna be black globally with these fools? We not on that. So you know what? If y'all want to do that B1, cool. But we black American first. That's what we is. We don't even use the B1 hashtag anyway. We never did, you know. But at the same time, it's cool. That's what it's on. But we black American. That's it. And them immigrants, they not black. And they don't like us saying that. That's the real issue. But other than that, brother, we not really causing no harm. We not, you know what I mean? We not, you know what I'm saying, pushing out no hatred, vitriol to no immigrants. We just letting them know our culture and our history and that they're not us. That, you know what I'm saying? They not us. That's what it
okay.
is. And
they now, okay, so that's your ideology. But if a person says, hey, if I go overseas and I see some black people who's cool with me, I'm a rock with them. And if they want to help me, I'll let them help me. Then if they need help from me, I'll help them. Would you respect that?
Oh, yes. I respected TBA. He said, I have an individual, a Nigerian. He brought up a Somali. And I'm like, yeah, that's cool. That's your individual. But we can't, we don't have time for that. We need groups. If that individual was not trying to get that Somali community in Minnesota on code together, we time wasting that. I mean, it's cool, individual. I'm not finna knock nobody money, bread if you got an individual situation. But, bro, if they're really talking about black liberation for us, they need to be worried about getting their people on code. Your Nigerian friend, go tell his Nigerian people in America, get on code. You need to be advocating for that. We don't have time to be getting our people on code because we got to deal with too many Sambos and Coons already in our own shit to worry about fixing other people and walking with them and trying to let them know how we don't have time for that. Like, you can just watch from afar and contribute, but you really can't input and politic in this. I'm sorry. Y'all had y'all chance and y'all missed it. And that's why people don't like us for saying that. That's just where we stand with it. But it's no hate or nothing. We just taking our culture back. That's all it is.
All right. Now, with that being said, the extremity of that is needed. Also, the diplomacy of us being global to a certain degree, that is also needed. Do you understand that?
Yes, I do understand that, because white supremacy is global.
Right.
But I just don't. Go ahead.
But because a lot of people, they've criticized your ideology, saying people from the diaspora, they ain't black. We ain't rocking with them. They ain't black. They ain't black. It's all about us. It's all about us. And people have been very critical of that, understandably so. But I understand, and to a degree, I respect the extremity of that, because our identity as foundational Black Americans has been so washed over. We need people who are bulldogging that shit, making sure that it's all about us, nobody else. We need some of that energy. That energy is needed. We got to respect that energy. We also have to respect there's some of us out here politicking in a different way. Me personally, I have a lot of brothers and sisters overseas who's connected to the media. So a lot of stuff that happens here, I got contacts with them and they'll put that stuff out and blast it all over the world. And then that helps us out. So all of it has to be respected. You understand?
Oh no, I respect it 100%. That, because white supremacy is global, and that's what they try to use. Like, we don't understand racism. No, we understand it. It's just other people don't understand it. They used to make fun of us. Y'all niggas black. Y'all don't know y'all lineage. Y'all don't know where y'all come from. So we we were wrong. We used to call them black. We were wrong. We understand that. Yeah, we've been wrong for decades. Them niggas are not black. We tripped out on that.
So,
and that's all it is.
Got it. So when we get in these rooms and we'll have some ideological differences, we just got to respect each other's differences, even if we don't rock in that direction, as long as we're foundational Black Americans, prioritizing foundational Black Americans first and our tangibles and our culture and understanding that we are a specific culture. As long as we establish that, all the other stuff is okay. People are cool with having their differences of ideologies and the way they look at other people in the diaspora. You feel me? Oh, where's Booby? Okay, Booby's out of here. Okay. Let's get we're gonna get a couple of people in. Let's get Seer of Saturn in here. I had this brother on before, I think. What's up, brother Seer of Saturn? Hop in, sir. Seer of Saturn.
To the tribe, piece of the family. No.
My man. Chime in, brother. What's your input on this?
Yeah, I agree with everything Booby just said. You know, I guess I'll speak my own perspective. I don't really follow B1. I never really paid attention to them. The red flag for me was when we held a space and we wanted to bring some clarity to what B1 is. And I heard, you know, a red flag from Afro Elite. He referred to Black, quote unquote. He said Black is a mentality. He said Black is a mentality. For me, Black is not a mentality. And I think that all of us in here, Secure the Tribe, we're saying, no, it's not a mentality. Black is my cultural identity. Black is my cultural identity. It's not a mentality. The food I eat is not a mentality. The language I speak is not a mentality. That's my culture. You know, the way my mom raised me, that's not a mentality. That's my culture. But, you know, the angle for me is I feel like the way he frames it, he takes my cultural identity as a Black man and turns it into an ideology when you call it a mentality. Because when you call it a mentality, you're saying, okay, now it's in the mind. It's something that anyone can study and read in a book and embody it overnight. That's not what Black is. You know what I'm saying? Black is a cultural doing. It's something that I inherited from my mother, my father, the land. Like when you look at the etymology of culture, it literally, like, it denotes, it says cultivated through the land. So when you say you're Black, you're saying this is my culture. You're saying that this was something that was raised through the land. It's not something you can just come and be overnight. You have to go through this. And it started with a Black classification. We're classified as Black, you know, centuries over, damn near 2 centuries ago, and then it flourished into a cultural identity. That's not a mentality. That's something that flourished and it, you know, it incubated and it became something beautiful to me. So I'm not gonna allow someone to take my Black cultural identity and turn it into, you know, a Black first and ideology to where other people can wear it for themselves. You know, they already have their ethnicity and their sovereignty. All I have right now for my cultural sovereignty is my Blackness. And we're saying, no, you cannot have that. That's mine. If you want to create like an international coalition, that's cool, but you're not going to use Black because that's erasure. Find another term that doesn't incorporate Black. Black belongs to me and my people. And you're not taking that and turning it into a mentality. It's not a mentality. You know, it's my blood, it's my sweat, it's my lineage. You know what I'm saying? It's my suffering. That's not a mentality for anyone to just like go to a school or reading a book and say, oh, this, like, it's like, it's not like a concept, like a political concept of, you know, socialism or communism or those are ideologies. Black is not an ideology. It is my cultural sovereignty. So that's all I got to say.
Got it. Now, let me, in defense of Afro Lee, in defense of him, I understand what he says when he says that it's a mentality, because you'll have somebody who's jet Black, who might even be FBA, who might have been in the same culture as you, brother, and me. We might have shared the same culture, but we'll have people like that come in our spaces and they'll be on some stuff. Well, I'm not Black, I'm LGBT. You see? So their mentality is wrapped around a different ideology, and the Blackness is secondary if it's even there at all. We've heard, and I don't like bringing this person up, T.S. Giselle, bring up his sexuality before his race. You understand? That's
yeah, common. I understand that. But I get you. Yeah, I get you.
When somebody says that Blackness is a mentality, that means you acknowledge that your culture is what's your
identity? See, that's the thing. Blackness, there's a distinction between Black and Blackness. Blackness is my aura. It's what I exude as a Black man. That's the residue of me being a Black man. My culture as I move is my Blackness. So someone can stand next to me and exude Blackness, but they're not Black. So Blackness could be in a way a quasi mentality, but it's not the same thing as saying Black. Black is me and my cultural identity. My Blackness is my aura, my collective people, our spirit, our music, our entertainment, our art. That's the Blackness. People can come in and, you know, emulate it, but they're not Black. They're just like exhibiting a shadow of who I am as an individual. Blackness and Black are not the same, but they're connected, but they're not the same. So we got to be mindful when we use that word Black. It's not the same as Blackness. You know what I'm saying?
There you go. All right, my man. I appreciate you, brother. Thank you so much, sir.
Peace, Bob. Peace.
All right. All right. Let's get co-ops. Co-ops or coops? Is it coops or co-ops?
It's in Black Power. It's coops, also known as B1 Beauty Supply. How are you? Peace and Black Power. Okay. Just wanted to come on real quick, Tariq. I haven't really spoken with you before, but I'm always in the spaces and YouTube and so forth. I'm coming in as an elder, as an older, probably older than most. First, I want to go ahead and recognize our brother, Richard Sudan, in the house. I appreciate brother Richard Sudan, because many times, just like you, I'll go ahead and tag him and post, because I know he's going to get, the happenings over there across the pond and let the folks know, what we're dealing with and try to draw his attention to some of the issues. I'm going to make it real, real short, Tariq, coming in from Honolulu by way of Oakland. I rock with Secure the Tribe. Those are much, much, much younger brothers. And the reason I do is, one, recognizing that we're in a war, we're in a race war, and I'm depending on the younger, able-bodied men to secure the tribe. In other words, I envision it this way. In the old days when the horse and buggies were going across the country into the West, you had to have the men out front, securing the rest of the folks coming behind, right? So that's kind of how I view it. I don't get into it for, club or, whatever else. To me, this is a serious thing that myself as an older woman am depending on the younger folks to secure the tribe, to keep their eyes out, to be boots on the ground. I'm doing my part, but I'm expecting the younger ones, the able-bodied ones, to be out there in front fighting. So that's why I appreciate what they're doing. Number two, I'm on delineating because we're trying to get reparations ready. I'm from California, born and raised. I'm looking for my reparations, and I'm trying to get as many people as possible to get your birth certificate, do your family tree, do whatever has to be done. We need to make sure we're separating out those who may be, quote, black in skin color from those who are truly have, ancestors who came from the killing fields of the South, of the American South. So I don't see a problem with delineating. As far as the black first, B1, I'm B1. I have B1 Beauty Supply. I like B1, right? But it doesn't pull in everybody around the world, though I appreciate all of our brothers and sisters in the diaspora. That's kind of a confusing thing we have to work through, but I see no problem at this point with all of these massacres of pulling together, securing each other, securing the tribe, loving our folks across the pond, whatever, if they are writers. But as our brother said, I think it was Booby, they need to talk to their people. If you rock with us, we appreciate it, but you you're not going to speak with for us. You're going to be on the outside reporting on what's going on, because as you know, as we do here, so goes the rest of the world, right? When we protest here, everybody else picks it up. So we have to pull together. So I'm for the delineation. I'm for securing the tribe. I've lived through the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, the 90s, the 2000, the 2010. I'm telling my age, 2020, right? So I hope y'all can put some respect on that. I'm just trying to give it a little... give your perspective from the other end of things. Yes. Okay, I appreciate you, though.
Thank you so much, beloved. Yeah, great insight with the elder sister. Listen, man, if you go to the official FBA website, dude, you talking about delineate, dude. We laid the rules down heavy on that site. Man, listen, we specified if you're a half FBA, if you're half anchor, half FBA, you will not be a representative of foundational Black Americans. Yes, you could be eligible for reparations, but if you have a dual allegiance, as far as your nationality, your parent is one from one group and you know, one parent is FBA, even though you are eligible to get tangibles when we do get them from slavery, you cannot or you should not be a representative for foundational Black Americans. Nobody with dual allegiances should speak for us. So I've been on that wave. Trust me, I'm already there. But it's all about respect too. When I say that, that doesn't mean that I don't respect riders from the motherland, riders from the Caribbean, because we still have them. We still have love for them. If I travel and they want to build, I'm always doing international business. I still rock with you as far as doing business as Black people, even though I'm a foundational Black American. I still look at that as another Black person, just like white people. They look at themselves as American, and that white person over in Australia looks at themselves as an Aussie. But when they get together, they're on code with each other. Let's be very clear. White people, when they get with other white people anywhere on the planet, their asses is on code with each other at the drop of a hat. Because if they're in any situation where there's danger, they look to each other for reinforcement. And I do the same thing. When I go places, especially if I go to somewhere in Asia or somewhere in Europe, and you know, one of these white supremacists out here want to break bad, I'm looking for a Black face for reinforcement. That's always good to have. That's always good to have. Now, that doesn't mean put the cape on and sing Kumbaya, whatever, but it's all about respecting Black people globally. It's all about respect and having people respect our foundational Black American lineage. That's the most important thing. When people come over here, and even people in the diaspora, they gotta have people respect our foundational Black American lineage. Now, again, with that being said, are there some brothers out here, some of our Secure the Tribe brothers who are riders? These are our young brothers, and they're riders. They got a lot of energy that we need. We need that. We need that. We also need the wisdom of the older brothers like TBA, Professor Black Truth, those brothers. We got to respect what those brothers bring to the table. They're not on some Pan-Africanism thing. I know their ideology. These brothers, they've been there, done that, so they have a certain level of wisdom that they can lace you with. It might be, you might perceive it as being disrespectful in a certain way, but sometimes when older cats lace you with some game or some information, a lot of times it ain't pretty because they're just gonna give it to you raw. Sometimes somebody's just gonna give that thing to you raw. It might rub you the wrong way, but they're going to give it to you without a filter. Respect that. We can respect that as long as what they're giving you is constructive. Our brother, Professor Black Truth and the Black Authority, what those brothers hit you with is constructive. Let's be real. We can't undermine and dismiss the game that these brothers drop. It's very constructive. They're not saying anything that's going to put Black people collectively in a janky place. Let's be clear on that. They're not some dudes who are coming around trying to infiltrate anything or undermine Black folks collectively. Also, in the same token, some of our brothers Booby and some of the other Secure the Tribe brothers, from who I know, some of them I know, some of them I don't know, but Sonny, Booby, some of those brothers, they've been pretty consistent. They're not trying to do anything to ultimately undermine us either. We have to understand we're on the same page as far as wanting foundational Black Americans to be straight, to have everything in order. That's what all of us want. Sometimes we might go about it some different ways. As long as the goal is the same, the route to those goals may be a little different, may not work for some other people, but understand they have the goal in mind. So we got this thing of criticizing everybody's techniques on how to do things. Look, all of us are needed. as long as we have the same goal. Everybody is needed. We don't have to be on some kumbaya. Everybody don't have to be perfect. Everybody don't have to be in agreement at all times about every little minor detail. Because right now, arguing about what does B1 mean and what does this mean, what does that mean? These are kind of minor details. We're all on the same page as far as the end goal. I want us to be focused on that because all of us are needed out here. We need everybody. We need the scholars. We need the street cats. We need the crackheads. We need the hoes. We need the strippers. Everybody is needed because everybody can bring something to the table that will ultimately bring us closer to getting what we need. Yes, they can. Everybody can. They have the potential to. I'll say that. Because if something goes down and some of these white supremacists start really breaking bad, we're going to need some of those crackheads to use their buggies, to run their buggies into the white supremacists. We're going to need some of those strippers to go catch one of these white boys and lure them in an alley and slit their throats or something. We're going to need some of that. We're going to need everybody to bring some to the table. We're going to need some of the moist cats to take their thong off and choke a white supremacist with them. Yeah. As long as, no matter what you do, we might have disagreements about your lifestyle, but when things go down, are you going to use your available resources to make sure that we stop the white supremacists from harming us and making sure that we are empowered as Black people, particularly as foundational Black Americans? That's my biggest concern. Man, we got a lot of folks in here. Again, we're going to be good, family. We're going to be good. We're going to be straight. We just got to get a lot of stuff off everybody's chests, get these disagreements out there, just get them on the table and understand that these disagreements, at the end of the day, it's water on the back of a duck's ass. It just rolls off because we're still going to be focused. We're going to be good. Let's not let this thing blow up where everybody's bickering over little bitty things. Look, we got a lot of momentum going as far as the California reparations. We got a lot of momentum going. We can't kill that momentum. We got to be laser focused, family. We got to be laser focused. A lot of times when Black folks get something going on, all of a sudden we get right there to the doorstep of empowerment, and then everybody just drops the ball and starts tripping and bickering over little bitty stuff. We got to start getting used to power and what power means. Because a lot of times on a subconscious level, a lot of us are scared of power. Right now, we're making power moves, elevating our own candidate, our good brother Marcel, getting our reparations claim really on some real legislation right now, getting that really, really popping, having them put out 500-page booklets talking about us. You understand? That's a monumental thing. We're not doing the victory lap yet. We're not doing the victory lap yet. Because a lot of times we start high-fiving each other. We want to do a big, we got a lot of places to go here. We got a long ways to go. But we're making strides. We got to stay focused, ladies and gentlemen. The little bickering and the petty stuff, that's cool. Because we need to get that out of our system. But at the end of the day, we're FBA family, and family gets into it sometimes. Sometimes you got a cousin or you got an uncle, whoever, that you beat the shit out of when you see him. But then you dust yourself off and then sit down at grandma's table and you eat that fried chicken and that damn potato salad and you keep that thing pushing. So yeah, we're going to have some family disputes here. That's what it is. Family disputes are healthy sometimes. That kind of lets everybody know the boundaries. But at the end of the day, respect everybody's opinion, respect everybody's techniques, as long as they're not trying to undermine us, the group, undermine us as a group. Man, what's up, Harriet Tubman's pistol? So let me see some Black hands up in here. Everybody, can I get a Black hand from every single person in here? Because there's over 1,000 people in here. It's 12 midnight here in L.A. It's like 3 out there on the East Coast. So I don't know what y'all asses are doing up this late. Can everybody in here give me a Black fist? everybody, even the people that's in the listening queue. I want to see a black fist from everybody. Black hand, black fist. There we go. Richard Sudan, let me see your black fist too, goddammit. Over there in the UK. I know you're over there eating some fish and chips for breakfast, but let me see your black fist too, Richard. Richard Sudan. Everybody. T.S. Giselle, take your finger out your pussy and let me see your black fist. You too. All right, everybody. I want to see a black fist from everybody in here, all walks of life. If you're a white man, take your hand out the mayonnaise jar. You put a goddamn black fist up. You represent. You in here lurking, ear hustling. Put your damn black fist up and represent. White folks. Because that's what it's going to be at the end of the day. It's going to be about foundational Black American empowerment, and then we'll turn that into global Black empowerment later on down the line once we get our house in order. But everybody has to put respect on it. Anyway, y'all, man, I appreciate y'all for tuning in. Yo, don't forget to go to the Kickstarter for the new movie American Maroon, talking about foundational Black American culture. Go to my pinned tweet on my Twitter profile. Go to my Tariq Radio YouTube channel. I got a very funny video up right now with a new puppet character that you guys got to see. That's on my Tariq Radio channel. Shout out to my brother Michael. Hold on. Should I get my brother Michael in here? Shout out to brother Michael. Hold on. I got to get one of my brothers in here. Hold on. I got to get my player partner in here real quick before I bounce. Hold on. Michael, what's up, brother? Let me get my brother in here. Real quick, if he gets his microphone working. What's up, Mike? Okay, my brother Mike, his microphone ain't working. But anyway, man, I'm out of here, man. Y'all be good. Peace.